Welcome to the Headless Professor video series. Our topic for today is validity in psychological measurement. When we say that a measure is valid, we only mean that it measures what it says it is going to measure, what it should measure, what it purports to measure. And the way that we establish the validity of a given measure is we show that it correlates with some kind of established or accepted measure of that particular variable. The way that we demonstrate this correlation is by putting it into something like this, a 2x2 contingency table. Now the rows here represent how each subject is going to be categorized in terms of performance on this new test or measure that we are trying to validate. For example, if this is a case of a clinical test, we're going to see if a new test which classifies a patient as having a disorder or not having a disorder stacks up and correlates with the reality of the situation, whether the patient really has the disorder or really does not have the disorder. Therefore, we're going to have 4 different cells, and each case will be classified into one of these 4 different cells. Here we are going to put those patients who the test says, yes, the disorder is present, and who actually have the disorder. And of course, every case in this cell, the diagnosis made by the new test was the right diagnosis. The patient really had the disorder. In this cell, we're going to put those patients that we call false positives. In other words, the test said, yes, the patient really has the disorder, but in reality, the patient did not have the disorder. The patient tested positive, falsely, for the disorder. In this cell, we're going to put those patients that really don't have the disorder, and the test called it right. The test said, no, the patient does not have the disorder. In this cell, we're going to put the false negatives. Patients who really had the disorder, but the test was not sensitive enough to pick up the disorder. If most of the patients are classified correctly in this cell and this cell, the test has some validity. How valid the test is depends upon the strength of the correlation between what the test says and what our established measure of reality said. The issue of validity is very important. It's important in clinical areas where we're talking about diagnosis and prognosis. It's also going to be very important in industrial psychology, where we are talking about predicting the performance of workers. If you like the Headless Professor video series or have any comments about these videos, please contact me, brink@usa.com.